the journey of music, there is something beautiful that I think that everyone has done in one way or another. Being music fan or professional, it's the personal journey of music. In my case, I'm sure in for many others too, I come from a rock pop context, or rock pop initial point, Deep Purple, Beatles, and then I discovered a man in a drum magazine announcing an instructional drum video. I didn't knew him at all. It was Dave Weckl. That video, I think, that changed my musical life because Dave took me to Chick Corea, Chick Corea took me to you, and then to all the GRP records, and from there to jazz, Brazilian, Latin, fusion. About GRP, John, that record label was a big thing, and I think a great point in your journey, right?
Absolutely, because before that, you know, I was writing a lot of music, but I didn't have a band. And when I got the gig with Chick around 85, you know, we hung out, we started making records and touring, and I would play my songs at the piano for him. And he said, "Man, what are you doing?" I said, "Well, what do you mean?" He said, "You should have a band and you should be recording." I said, "Yeah, but how am I going to get a record deal? I'm a bass player. Nobody wants to sign a bass player." He said, "I'll take care of that." So Chick was the one who got me the record deal.
Great.
With GRP. And then they said, "Okay, we want to hear demos." He said, no, "You'll hear the record when it's finished." And then they said, well, they asked Chick, "Will you help produce the record?" So the first record, he helped me. He taught me about making records and budgets and, you know, producing records. And he said, "I'll do whatever you need me to do to help." And I said, "Well, will you play too?" And he did.
That's a fantastic experience, John. Thank you. Those solo records that you did have some of the most incredible fusion music of all time, having in your albums the Breaker Brothers, Chick Corea, Eric Marienthal, John Scofield, and some of the best drummers of all time. Can you share with us some experiences and situations of those recording sessions? For example, creating the grooves for the songs, or the production or recording process of your first solo albums?
Well, I was very excited to get this opportunity. What Chick did was he let us use Mad Hatter Studios in the nighttime from 6 p.m. to the next morning, mm-hmm. if we needed to, and for a very low price. So I had already been playing with Vinny for years, and then I had, you know, and then I was starting to play with Dave a lot, with Chick we toured a lot. I was lucky and blessed to play with all these amazing drummers. So, you know, with them, once they heard what I wrote, they always knew exactly what to do. If I had a little idea, I would just say, "Well, it's kind of like this sound," and boom, you know, they created.
Yeah. I was so excited, man. I could barely sleep last night. Chickster!
Chick, what are you doing? Frankie.
Come on, Frankie.
There is another period of your life, from the past, the present, and I think the future too, with one of the greatest bands of all time, the Chick Corea Electric Band or Acoustic Band. I think that one or two of the secrets of that incredible group are incredible compositions by Chick Corea and the word band.
Yeah, yeah.
What are the main reasons for the success of that iconic band, John?
Well, we stayed together for a long time. We had 10 years solid. You know, I talk a lot about this at Berklee College of Music, where I teach with Danilo. And I think the greatest music, and especially a lot of the music that this, our music comes from African music, so the roots, and how that spread to all the countries. And that's a community music. It's based on community. You learn the rhythms in community, you learn to sing in community, everything's in community. I think the greatest advancements in music are with groups of people. Maybe there's a band leader who writes some music, but the band makes the music go to the highest level, because you need that family to make the music really powerful. It's not just one person.
I know that your first playing session with Chick Corea was in a party. Chick loved your playing, and you sent him some tapes of you playing, and then you were included in the band. You were the first one hired. You didn't know Weckl at that time, and I think that you recommended for the drum chair to your close friend Benny Colaiuta. How was that situation, and how was your first connection with Dave?
You know, the thing was, when I talked to Chick about it, he said, oh yeah, I talked to Mike Brecker and I asked him who was the best young drummer in New York, and Mike Brecker said Dave Weckl. So I was like, okay, I got to hear this guy, you know. And then he flew out to LA, and first rehearsal, you know, it was easy. It just started immediately.